Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today I'm going to show you how to clean the carburetor on our 2003 Honda Rancher 350 two-wheel drive manual. Pretty simple to do, just need to get the air box pulled out of the way, remove the carburetor, then we'll get it over to the teardown bench and I'll pull it apart and show you how to rebuild it. So if you're ready, we can get started. All right, this is going to be a skill level 2. But let's go over some of the tools that we're going to need to get this done. 10 millimeter with a fairly long extension, a Phillips, a flat blade. Also, you want to make sure you have a long reach Phillips. Not sure if we're going to need it, but if we have any Phillips screws that are tough, going to need one of these impacts. Other than that, need a 7 millimeter, a 10, and a 14 millimeter just regular wrench, a pair of needle nose pliers, a pair of side cutters, pick tool, and just a soft blow hammer. Now, as far as the parts, you'll want to reference our parts diagrams, and there's one of two ways you can go about doing this. You can either A, just go with a kit from Moose, which has all the pieces, or you can reference the parts diagram, which has everything exploded out, which you could reference to pick out the particular parts that you may need to rebuild your particular machine. Plus, it makes it a lot easier looking at the diagrams when it comes time to put it all back together. So, once you have your tools and the parts that you need for your machine together, we'll go over there and I'll show you how to do it. All right, let's start by going ahead and turning off the fuel. What you want to do is turn the petcock over on this side, just 90 degrees, and that'll shut it off. And I'm going to go ahead and loosen up these two clamps. There's one going to the carburetor and then there's one going up to this upper breather tube, and now you're looking for a section at the bottom of the airbox assembly, and it's just one 10 millimeter bolt that we're trying to get to. There it is. Now you should be able to just pull this back off the carb and then move that intake tube off of it as well. All right, to give us a little bit more working room, we're going to remove this little plastic rivet. Remove the crankcase breather hose. It just has a little spring clamp on it. I'd go ahead and take it off so you don't lose it, because it's going to come up with the airbox. Now we can go ahead and remove the front clamp that is going to the intake. It'll be facing the right side of the machine, and it's on the bottom. So just loosen that up. And now I want to go ahead and disconnect the negative on the battery. Now, what we're doing right now doesn't involve with anything with turning on the machine. I just want to go ahead and remove any possibility of any sparks at all, because now that it's actually disconnected from the machine, it still has fuel in the bottom of the float bowl, and as I start to move it around, it's going to leak and it's going to run down the back side of the engine. So we want it to be electrically dead so we don't ignite that fuel. We've got a few different vent hoses we need to disconnect. We need to go ahead and do the throttle and the choke. And the throttle's actually behind this plastic cover right there. That's just held in a single Phillips. Lift that cover up, and then it just pulls out like that. Now, we can go right here, where the cable goes into the top of the carb, push that boot up, and just loosen up that pinch bolt. And once you've got that, then you can back this all the way out, and now we can feed it through this channel and then swing it all the way around to where it lines up with this other channel at the bottom of this arm, and then we're just going to pull it straight up. Next, we need to remove the choke cable, and it just threads straight in. And this is just plastic, so remember, when you're putting this back together, you really don't have to crank down on it very much. Right, the reason we're actually pulling this one apart to clean it is the machine would start, but after that it really didn't want to idle. So that's typically indicative of what they call the slow jet, or the small jet being stopped up. All right, there's one more connection we need to get. It's actually an electrical connection right here. Reach in where this little section is, where my finger is, and this little plastic tab, pull that toward you, and then that'll release the connector. Nice and nasty. All right, she is out. So let's take her over to the teardown bench and get it pulled apart. All right, before we start splitting this open, let's use a little bit of our contact cleaner to get this cleaned up a bit, because, well, we're trying to keep all of this out of it, you know? So I'm gonna go ahead and flip it upside down, go ahead and empty out the float bowl. Definitely have on a pair of glasses when you do this. because you do not want to spray this and have it go back into your eyes. We're going to start by getting the slide out of the way. And depending on if your carburetor has ever been pulled apart or not, sometimes these Phillips can be hard to break loose. Now this one obviously is not that bad a shape, but if it were, these are very easy to strip out. So if you haven't bought one of these little just manual impacts, you need to pick one up. Get it like that, pop it, and that shock will break it loose. You'll notice the carburetor is on a piece of wood. That's to keep up, you know, from potentially scarring up or breaking the bottom of the float bowl. Now take notice where this hose clamp is. Just keep in mind that it's across from where the throttle cable is connected. Get out our spring. You want to look around the diaphragm, see what kind of shape it's in. Make sure there's no holes anywhere on it, no rips, no tears. Next, let's go and get off our float bowl. Same scenario with the screws on the bottom. If they don't want to immediately break loose, then you want to get out that impact again. Yeah, not too bad. I do see a little bit of sediment down in the bottom, and plus you can see this kind of green gel around here. You can also tell it's been a while since anybody's been in here, because that lower O-ring is flat as a pancake. So I'm really surprised it wasn't leaking. So the kit I'm using is actually from Moose Racing, and it actually comprises all the different jets and adjustment screws and the valve needle seats and the springs and everything that you would need to rebuild this. All right, let's go and get that float bowl pin out. If it was in there the same way it was from the factory, it actually has a set of splines, if you're looking at the carburetor from the bottom, right there. So we want to push it toward that direction. So we want to take this bottom edge and just rest it on the edge of the wood. That way we reduce the chance that we're going to actually break the carburetor. There. Now, go ahead and pull that out, and then lift out the float. And as you can see, that little needle just dropped right off. So, looking at it, it was a little green. It wasn't leaking or anything like that, but you can see a little bit of a groove where it was resting in its seat. All right, let's go and get the main jet out. And I pretty much know that this is going to be open, but if you hold it up and you can't see through it, it's definitely stopped up. But that one looks to be okay. Now here's the one I believe that is stopped up. It's what they call the idle jet. And no, I cannot see through this one. Now granted, it's going to be a much smaller diameter hole, but I should be able to see some type of light coming through there, and I can't. The other thing I want to take a look at is the idle mixture screw, which is on the back side. Now, to determine where it was set from the factory, which I think is probably 2 1/4 turns, we can take it and just mark where it was and go all the way in and see where it stops. And there's a couple of different pieces to it. You have the main section there, and then there's also a spring. Down at the very bottom is a tiny little O-ring and a washer. What I want to do at this point is use some of our carburetor cleaner, because I think we can just spray out some of these orifices and then get her put back together. If you don't think you could see down through the jet, what you can do is actually use some of your carburetor cleaner and just put it at the top and see if you can squirt it through the end. That should be flowing straight through, but it's barely burbling through. This one is stopped up, and that is for certain. Before we start actually blowing out the different passageways, let's go ahead and get some of this crud cleaned off the bottom. Be careful not to gouge any of this surface. I'm actually just using the edge of this. All this stuff comes off fairly easy. I just want to give the new O-ring a fighting chance of actually sealing up, you know. All right, so let's spray out this choke. Then we can go to the idle. Air fuel. Main, I pretty much already know it's going to be open. And then let's make sure there's nothing in where the float jet goes. All right, so let's start putting her back together. Some pieces I will replace, others I will stay with the factory. Let's start with our pilot jet. This one looks like it's seen better days, so we're going to go with a new one. But let's build it up. So the real trick here is to get it all lined up, keep it vertical, and put it all in there as one assembly. We're going to bring it in until the bottom's out. Just go in until it lightly seats. All right, at this point, the factory setting is to come out 1 3/4. Now, I counted when we took it apart, somebody had it set to right at 2 1/4. So I'm going to split the difference and just come out 2 turns. And the reason that this even exists, you can adjust for your different changes in altitude. If you were running at a real high altitude, you'd only run this maybe 1 turn out versus 2. Next, let's go ahead and take a look at what I call our slow jet. There are no O-rings. Let's go ahead and drop her in. And this one, you just go until it's seated. All right, our main is actually made up of 2 different pieces. You actually have the jet that goes up top, and then you have this, what they call it, emulsification tube that goes into the carburetor. So this piece is actually 2 separate pieces, but believe me, they are welded together by this point. But you put those together, and that's what you end up with. All right, I do want to put just a little bit of torque on that so it doesn't come apart. Don't over tighten, just snug it down. There's also one they call I think it's a start jet. It has something to do with the priming bulb on the side. Since we're in it, they sent it with the kit. Let's go ahead and pop it in there. All right, with that, I am going to go ahead and replace the float bowl needle. Just slide it into that slot, leave it in this position so it doesn't fall out. Got it back in there. Go ahead and push that pin back through. And we want to use our little piece of wood again, rest it on the edge, and just tap it back in. It doesn't have to be flush. There's plenty to hold it in place. All right, lay in our O-ring. Make sure it's in the groove all the way around. And take your carburetor, working with gravity. There. You may or may not have noticed that there's still several pieces left over from the kit. Actually, I'm not going to be using the new ones. I'm going to keep in the factory. Let's go ahead and put this slat assembly back in. Make sure that this section lines up right there. Go ahead and put it in our spring. And put on that upper cover and make sure that that section lines up with that little protrusion on the corner. This little clamp, remember, went opposite of where the throttle cable comes in. So it goes over on this side. All right, well, that's got it back together. Let's take it back over to the machine and get reinstalled. Before we get the carburetor on, I mean, some of our rubber hoses, they're starting to show some wear. I didn't order new ones. I didn't realize they were broken. What we're gonna do is we're gonna cheat a little bit. We're just gonna trim them down, cut off the bad section, and see if we can reattach them and get this little clamp in place to hold it. We'll just do everything else back in reverse. I guess we'll do the choke cable next. Rotate it over and get our throttle cable in there. Very careful not to cross-thread it. That looks about right. Then remember to bring that upper boot back over the top of it. Let's get on these 2 vent lines. First one goes here, and the other one is over on the other side, right here. And put that little clamp over the top of it. Go ahead and get our fuel line back on. There's one more piece that needs to go on, and that is this cover for the throttle cable. It slides into that little slot at the bottom, and it's just one screw for that large washer. Now let's slide it back on the intake boot. Make sure it's vertical. We're gonna tighten down that clamp. Now we can go ahead and get our air box back on. We've got the that pickup tube that's running up here for the air intake. Make sure it's all the way flush up there. All right, let's go ahead and get these tightened down. All right, don't forget this little plastic rivet. Then getting this little 10 millimeter on the bottom of the air box itself. And the last connection we need to make is for that little carb heater wire. Grab it, bring it across, and get it plugged back in. And the last thing we have is this little vent right here for the crankcase. Now, hook up the battery, we'll turn the gas back on and see what it does. That's sounding a whole lot better. All right, you'll notice when I first started it up, it was idled way high. You wanna know why that was? Evidently, this thing's had a problem with that slow jet being stopped up. And how they compensated for it is they brought the idle up to where it more or less bypassed the low circuit to keep it what it was supposed to be doing. They actually went into the high circuit to make the machine idle. So pretty much figured that was going to happen. So it's definitely good to go now. So all we've got to do now is just get our seat back on, and she's ready to go hit the trail. Well, listen, if you need any of the parts that we use to do this, come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.